Skirmish League. Hello, fans, as Mecca would say, and welcome to Skirmish League Live. This is Prisoner filling in for Romulox as his squad, Angry Frogs, are currently facing the Statutory Apes. With me, co-hosting, I have Yosh, the captain of Instant Vintage. Hey, Yosh, good to have you here.
What's going on, man? Thanks for having me.
All right, so like I said earlier, we have Angry Frogs against Statutory Apes. And I gotta say, I hope this game is closer than the first one of this evening, in which we saw Cobra Kai roll over Legends. I believe it was 123-17. What are your predictions for the final score, Yosh?
For this game, I think the predictions are going to be fairly high. I'm going to say 95-33, with the Frogs winning it, with ER having like 20 kills.
All right, fair enough. So, not giving a ton of respect to Statutory Apes as the underdog here. I tend to agree with you. I'm going to scale it back just a little bit. I'm going to say 75-40.
That's pretty generous.
It's a bit generous, but you know what? Statutory Apes, since we did the SL Live preseason rankings, these guys have probably SB'd more than any other squad. They were really inactive before, and I'm looking at their lineup right now, and I mean, it's looking pretty good. I mean, Josh, I know you've played with them a lot yourself. Nosekeeper, pretty good Marine. Versace's a good Marine. Black Crusader, a.k.a. Mike C, has been around for a while. Which of these guys on Apes do you think are their key players, Josh?
I think Nosekeeper, it's his era this year. Last year was the Iceman era, a little disappointing, but this year is the Nosekeeper era. And I also think David Bowie, a.k.a. Negi, is going to be an important player for them this game. If he can keep them alive, expect them to pick up some pretty good kills.
All right, so you're predicting Nosekeeper for Rookie of the Year. I think I would agree with you there. Negative zero, I mean, it certainly depends on how many beers he's had up to this point. Sunday nights are a bit iffy. I think the earlier the better.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Let's look at Angry Frogs real quick before this starts. Looks like they both have eight in. You mentioned ER leading the kills. Is he their key player?
Yeah, it's going to be ER, Pandy, and surprisingly Deviac over there, keeping them alive. It'll be on those three to pretty much carry the load here for the Frogs.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think the Chaos Blade is also a great player, and obviously they have Darth leading. So the Frogs' Marine lineup actually looks really strong right now. I would say the weak link is probably Plissken, and that guy's a vet. You know, he's been playing forever, so I'm assuming he'll be able to be a good support Marine, keep some good positioning. Let's look at the meds real quick. Statutory Apes, we have AYB, and I believe, as you mentioned, Negative Zero, a.k.a. David Bowie medding. How do you feel about the Apes med situation?
Well, I'm going to be honest here. AYB, he's new to the league. He's coming in. I hear he's going to try and lead them like KVQ in the past. We're starting the game here.
Yeah. Definitely. AYB is hungry. So, I mean, Angry Frogs meds, Romulox and Victim. We have a few seconds before they get into a battle. Two vets, a bit faded, so we'll see how they do in this game, if they can unfade and get back to their former glory on War Dogs and such way back in the day in Skirmish League. So it looks like...
Yeah, I don't have too much experience with them guys, so we're going to have to see if they can unfade or not.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that was, you know, 15 years ago. It looks like we have both squads going into mid right now. The Apes coming into mid from the west door, kind of setting up, ambushing south. And it looks like Frogs are walking right into them. This could be a really good first battle. This is really bad for Angry Frogs. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Get him, Apes. Get him.
Go, Apes. Go. Kill Win.
Oh, no. That could not have started worse for Angry Frogs. Oh, man. They have to retreat
Pandy's
outside
down.
Of mid. ER is stuck in the bottom right, running away in a 1v1 versus Versace. He laws a wall.
ER's trolling.
ER, what are you doing? I'm glad I got that on camera.
He's trolling.
ER, I think, is the most picked up fantasy player for week one, and he just lawed a wall. Let's get back
to the
battle.
I mean, that's tough for Angry Frogs.
Yeah, they're down 3-1 at this point. Still fighting in mid. Great start from the Apes, though. Can't say I expected that. Certainly caught Angry Frogs by surprise. I mean, they had a really good setup. Read them like a book.
I mean, what you got to understand about the Apes is these guys are hungry, they want to learn, they want to improve, and they want to get better. And they understand that they don't have any experience in the league, and they're gonna use a lot of these kind of camping-style plays just to keep themselves in the games, more than likely.
Definitely, definitely. And that's the way to go. I'm impressed by whoever's leading. I don't know if it's M or AYB, but kudos to those guys. I know they've been practicing a lot of strats, so we'll see if it pays off. Looks like we have Angry Frogs down by what is known as a Cock Rock, and Apes set up north in G1, kind of around that building, hiding on some physics.
Yeah, this is a thing that Apes like to do. They like to hide guys in that building for whenever somebody pushes out the south or the north mid. They get collapsed on here. But this is the only flaw in this plan, is if they come from the bottom. They don't really have any vision down here, and expect them to get cleaned up right here.
I mean, AYB almost got caught out of position there. And Versace is way out of position. I don't see how he lives here. Caught in the middle, unfortunately. It's going to be the opening kill for Angry Frogs. Yeah, Versace goes down. Interesting to note, though, they still have four guys in the G1 building, and if they can just lure the Frogs, that's a really, really good ambush. People don't check there. Let's see what happens.
No, they need to go. They need to go. They need to go and hit the laws here.
They gotta time it. They gotta time their laws. Oh, they naded it. Wow. Heads up play. Heads up play.
Well, the Apes have been using that play for a long time, so it's not out of the realm of possibilities that they would all be there. Like, this isn't something new. The Apes have pretty much done this in every SP that they've had, so.
Fair enough. I mean, great call by Darth there, regardless. It's kind of hard, you know, throwing those blind nades. I mean, it really opened up the fight. Nosekeeper with a double law! Oh my god!
Oh man!
Nosekeeper,
the
you're rookie of
real
the year position! Apes are turning on the West group. Oh my god, they should get these kills. They need to kill Pandy fast.
Oh!
Pandy down.
ER goes down.
Oh my god. Apes completely turned it around. They're down 8v6. Nosekeeper with a double law and then another kill. Oh, they caught a couple Frogs guys out of position there. They got a bit too aggressive on the flank.
Yeah, that was just... Darth needs to get it together and show these guys a little bit of respect. Like, they're going to be hiding on physics and walls for pretty much the whole game. If they just start rolling as, like, a more tighter group and stop soloing off so much, they should just be able to pick them off out in the open. Because the Angry Frogs have a lot better Marines than the Apes.
I agree with you 100% there. I have to wonder if Darth is a bit on tilt right now. He's about a quart ahead of his team. Okay, he's slowing up a little now. But he's got to chill. Like, they have to take the next battle clean. Certainly an unexpected start. Oh, no, they're walking into the same ambush again. Please don't go down.
Oh.
They're stopping.
I think Darth's a veteran leader. He's gonna get his guys to regroup. They're going to fucking just calm down a little bit and start taking these battles a little bit slower, get a little bit more organized, and stop falling into these traps.
Looks like Apes are falling out of West Mid. Pretty smart call there to change it up a bit, but see if they can avoid these laws. Oh my god, I don't know how AYB lived there.
That's very, very lucky.
How did AYB live?
He should have been killed there.
Yeah, we see the LOLs and the Raffles in chat right now. some pretty bad laws from Angry Frogs, to tell you the truth. They should have had 2 kills there.
The Apes need to watch this West Mid. You don't want them all to push out down here.
Yeah, it looks like Frogs are leaving one in West, and then they went around the South. Apes is holding. They're setting up another ambush. Oh, that North team could be dead. They just gotta live. Oh, no. This is it. Nice law. Opening kill on Rom.
The ambushes are real.
Oh, Chaos Blade, though. Cleaning it up. Chaos Blade with 3 kills so far in the battle. Running for his life. 4 kills for Chaos Blade. Wow. Chaos Blade almost single-handedly kept them in that battle with 2 shotgun kills and an AR kill, I believe, at the end. That should have been a win for Apes. They just got outskilled.
Yeah, and that's... You're going to run into that problem in this game. Like, expect this to start getting a little bit ugly from here. Once the Apes can't camp anymore, and they have to actually start fighting them out in the open, these battles are going to go really bad really fast, I think.
Yeah, I 100% agree with you. I'm just glad that we have a game on our hands. Right now, it's 12-9 for Statutory Apes. If you don't mind, Josh, can you check the breakdown and tell me who's leading us in kills and leading us in deaths real quick?
Yeah, we got Chaos Blade and Pandy with 4-1 each. The Nosekeeper, the Rookie of the Year, at 3-1. And most deaths are Darth, Deviac, Pandy, Versace, AYB, and Negi. So the Apes' meds need to really stop dying. If they can start staying alive a little bit longer, the Apes can actually stay in this game. I'm really happy right now for the Apes, because these guys, nobody expected a lot of them, obviously. And they're showing that, you know what, given a couple weeks, they actually might be able to surprise some squads here.
I mean, they're winning. They're ahead 12-9. So it looks like we have another North ambush again with some guys on the T-shirt building. Not really a good look, though.
Oh. Unless
they can get this kill. Yeah. Missed the law. Theorem missed the law.
Yeah. That's just execution right there.
Yeah, it looks like they're dead.
Expect
on the
these
left.
Battles to go bad.
8v5
This
now
is going to go bad.
Frogs. Yeah. Just got to get as many kills as possible at this point. Try to keep it close. Save some deaths. Looks like that was a 6-0 so far this battle for Frogs. Sorry, my mistake.
And this is more what I expected them.
Yeah, this is what we all expected. It was 12-9 for Frogs, my mistake, not for Apes. And now it's 18-9 for the Frogs.
I mean, I've seen the Apes, they've went north every fight so far, and they've lost the last 2 fights up north. They should try and change it up a little bit and just go south.
Are you seeing this game chat, Josh? A bit of trash talk going on here between Deviac and AYB. AYB says, I can't lead his med, and Deviac responds, you don't think we wouldn't recognize Kippa tactics, right? This ain't 2002. Laying down the smackdown.
And AYB says, I don't know who Kippa is, so...
I mean, that tells
me... I mean, how do you insult the guy when he doesn't even know who the other guy is?
Yeah, AYB's got to keep his head together. He's got to be calm. Calm as the leader in this game.
I'm really surprised that Big Bird isn't in this game to help out AYB with just helping out leading. Because with Bird in the game, they could certainly have a little bit more like regroup together time, and he'd be able to just be like a calming influence, and he'd provide a lot of experience on this on the team.
Absolutely, I agree with you 100%. It looks like Apes had an ambush planned, and they gave up on it. Unfortunately, they just walked into angles. Lucky if they don't die here. Furion narrowly avoided a death. Good heals from Neg.
Yeah, Neg's doing his best to keep him in the game. AYB really needs to stop dying first every battle. That's been a problem with him, and just a new medic in general for starting out. If he stops dying first, they could actually pick up some kills here.
I agree with you 100%. Obviously, those early medic deaths hurt you so much in USL. Good fall, nevertheless, by the Apes. It looks like Frogs is turning on the North group. Black Crusader caught way out of position. He's going to go down, it looks like. If he lives, it'll be a miracle. Black Crusader down. This left team is in trouble here.
Yeah, expect this to, for the next 20 minutes to be at, for them to be at their base. The apes started off really strong, but in the end, like, they just don't have enough experience in their game plan to be able to just hold a squad like the frogs off here.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, they have to be happy with how the first two battles went. They haven't got a kill in two battles, though, I believe. They just took five deaths. ER crossed the rape lines. Just toying with them at this point.
ER's toying with everybody's fantasy hearts as well.
Oh, no. I thought ER might go Ripper for this game, but it looks like he went back to Marine last minute. We saw him rip in a bunch of SBs this week. Probably the better choice as Marine, but can you check his score for me real quick, Josh?
Yeah, ER is currently 2-1. For the most pick fantasy drafted player, he's not really holding up to that right now.
No, ER's got to step it up. I want to see him get at least 3 kills next battle. I'm going to keep my eye on ER. It looks like he's going to get overloaded there on the top.
But Pandy is going nuts here at 10-2 right now.
ER
down.
He
finally stopped playing League for a little bit. Oh, no.
ER 2-2. Damn, he's on my fantasy team.
I took both ER, Pandy, and Deviac, so...
Hedging your bets a bit there. That's pretty smart. I think I have Pandy as well.
Oh.
Despite getting that opening kill on ER, it looks like Angry Frogs is cleaning up. I don't believe anyone else has died. We have a 3v2 north, and they're about to get flanked. Good kill.
The Nosekeeper gets Romulox.
Nosekeeper got two there, somehow, I believe. Deviac and Rom. Is he the leading player for Apes right now? Can you tell me a bit about their stats, Josh?
Yeah, right now you have Nosekeeper actually at 5-3 going positive in this game. He holds a large percentage of their kills. After that, it's just kind of bad. Everybody else has one kill, maybe.
It looks like Frogs is subbing. It's down to 6v8. ER and Pandy are out.
Oh, no!
That is not good for the collective.
Everybody who had ER on the fantasy team.
Yeah, that's not good. Apollo says, I can't believe I paid 140 points for ER. What a ripoff. Yeah, that seems to be the general sentiment in chat right now. Darth is...
Everyone's highly upset about this.
Darth is trying to win USL Fantasy, it looks like, with those subs.
Oh, no.
Some insider information going on here, that's for sure. I don't think he would have benched them if he had them in Fantasy.
No, I don't think so either, but... He wants to get all of his guys playing time. Universal Soldier and Zeeb also came in for ER and Pandy. We'll see how this new team does. 15 minutes is a long time, and without their leading two Marines, it could actually go really bad here for the Frogs.
Yeah, I mean, they're only down by 21. That's a bit under 3 battles. Real quick, let's talk about Zeeb. Wasn't he on Apes last week? What happened?
Well, apparently Zeeb, he didn't mesh well with the squad. I mean, his first act as co-captain was to kick Kumo out. And then after that, I guess he just decided that he'd rather go play with more pals, as they say.
I mean, fair enough. I'm all for people playing with their friends. We'll see if that maybe motivates Apes a little bit here to put it on their former squad mate, Zeeb.
I'm really surprised Templar's not in the game right now. This is actually very sad to me. I have him on my fantasy team. I thought he would play well this game and be able to actually keep up in this game, but...
I see Pandy doing a little bit of trolling in spec chat. I believe he said, good game, Nublords. RIP Fantasy.
Oh, no.
Tactical begging for him to go back in. The fantasy implications are real. Looks like we have Frogs going into north mid.
And we have the apes at the south mid entrance. So we should be seeing a fight relatively soon here. And if the if the Apes can just get some momentum here, they can actually try and make a comeback here. But yeah, it'll be on the Nosekeeper to kill probably everybody here.
I mean, he's doing pretty well so far. It looks like all the frogs are inside mid right now. They're currently sending a flank west. Should be about an even battle here between west and south mid. Chaos Blade sitting solo in the barrels here. It's going to ambush someone.
Yeah, Deviac says quite a few of you guys must hate ER right now. I mean, he was the most picked player in fantasy and ended up going 2-2. I mean, looks like these guys were just trolling the whole time. Pandy's like, GG, get trolled, Nub Lords.
Yeah, I believe that's the first time that he's called SpecChat. Or sorry, the fifth time he's called SpecChat Nub Lords during this match since being subbed. It looks like we have a bit of a stalemate here. Nobody really pushing. Apes kind of ambushing outside of mid with the frogs inside. This might be a good time to check the scoreboard. Can you tell me about the meds, Josh, if you don't mind? How are Victim and Romulox doing in this game?
Romulox is actually 1-2, and Victim is 2-0 right now. So it looks like Victim's actually trying to shake off a little bit of that rust. I saw Romulox take a pretty bad death to the Nosekeeper, but other than that, it seems like they're doing fine this game.
A Victim definitely stepping it up. 2-0 is pretty impressive. It looks like we might have a bit of a push here. Apes coming into south mid. Apes eating a log.
Not a AYB going happened. Down really fast. Yeah. I mean, he's got to stop eating log. Chaos Versace played with another good log and Versace. Yeah.
I mean, at this point, Apes has to be falling. They can't win 6v8 with one med. Just got to save the deaths here. These guys south mid are going to get overrun. Looks like it's a 5v2. They have no med. There's no way they can hold that door.
I mean, AYB says he usually plays 500 times better. They're wanting the forfeit now, but they just need to stay in the game, try and take as much experience as they can, and just try and get some win, or try and get a battle. It's all a learning experience 100%. For these guys.
Yeah, I mean, AYB, you know, they could learn a thing or two from Chica. We just had her in our post-game interview. Even when her squad was getting rolled, you know, she said that the mid was pretty light on vent, and they're still having fun, so I hope that Apes keeps their heads up. Looks like they got a couple
kills. The Nosekeeper taking another one down. Oh, almost takes Devian down as well.
Victim dies for the first death. It looks like Apes are putting it on them here. Their respawn is back in the fight, but unfortunately Versace down. AYB is about to go down.
AYB's dying twice in the same battle. That can't happen. He needs to position himself a little bit better. Stay off of corners and just try not to die twice in the same fight. He really needs to step up his game for these guys to be in these games. He can't be dying first.
We have some shit talk going on in spec chat here. I believe Babel's a member of Statutory Apes. Is that correct, Josh?
Yeah. Babel's a big-time member of the Apes. And him and Chaos Blade just don't like each other.
Yeah, Babel's talking about stealing his girl. fair enough. I don't know how you're going to do that with Infantry, but, you know, good luck.
I mean, it's happened before, to be honest. There's been instances of that, so...
We're not going to bring this up in the official Skirmish League Live broadcast brought to you by USLZone.com. Check out USLZone.com for all of your Infantry Skirmish League information and freeinfantry.org to pick up a copy of the game, which is free. Looks like another battle here. Apes is rolling as one group. Not a good look for them. They're about to get pinched. DVAC coming underneath with a great angle. They're cleaning up the top.
The Apes are actually up here.
Yeah. They did a great job pushing north. Nosekeeper, their number one Marine, just cleaned up the top. And the bottom players did a great job staying alive. I believe they only had one death this battle. They're gonna take it.
The Nosekeeper is putting in work right now. That guy is... He's showing the league, you know what, there is still new talent being developed, and he's one of them guys right now. He's really doing a good performance here.
Absolutely. I'm really impressed by the Nosekeeper, as you affectionately like to call him. Looks like Pliskin and Deviac got away. That was a pretty clean fight by Apes. I believe it was 6-1 or 6-2. With 9 minutes left to go, the score is 45-23 in favor of Angry Frogs. With Pandy still in first place, although he's been in spec for about 7 or 8 minutes now. They subbed at around 15.
Yeah, the Chaos Play is actually doing very well this game at 10-2. Pandy at 11-3. Deviac and the Nosekeeper at 10-2 each, and most deaths is AYB and Versace at 7 deaths apiece.
Sorry, that Nosekeeper can't be 10-2. What's his record?
Well, he's 10-4. He's 10-4.
10-4 when your squad is down 45-23 is an incredible record. He's having a monster game. I'm going to spec Nosekeeper for a while here, see what he can do in these last 8 minutes. It looks like Apes is kind of ambushing mid. They have some guys going northeast. Frogs were by Cockrock. They're pushing around the west side of mid, so it looks like we have both squads going opposite directions at this point. It might be a while before the next battle. They're going to run in a big circle here.
So, Prisoner, who do you have on your fantasy team? Who are you rooting for in this game? Do you have any invested interest in this one?
I mean, I believe I played Pandy and ER. I'm not 100% if I put Romulox in or not. He might have been my med, actually. So he's been doing pretty well. It looks like Victim would have been a monster fantasy pickup for anybody. I'm not sure how many rosters he was on, but definitely he would have been a big one. I doubt that.
Yeah, there was a lot of.
Sorry, Josh. Go ahead.
No, I don't think anybody picked up the Apes.
Looks like we
Champion apparently says he's deleting Pandy and ER from the site. There's quite a few salty people in the spec right now about this fantasy.
Yeah, definitely some trolling from Angry Frogs. It looks like they're having some fun with this game, which is pretty good. I mean, they probably could have more kills if they really put it on them, but still 45-23 is a pretty good result so far. Again, both teams kind of running around the map. It looks like we finally might see a battle here with the Frogs pushing around east mid, Apes going into south. I'm not sure if they had vision or not. It looks like Frogs are going into the rocks. I don't think they saw each other. Darth and chat, WTF are you guys doing? It's been a while since a battle. They've just been running in opposite directions. It happens sometimes in USL, unfortunately.
Yeah, the Apes just can't get too down on themselves about this. I mean, this is their first time, you know, in an actual league match. I don't think hardly any of these guys have any experience in the league. And for all intents and purposes, they did pretty well. I mean, it wasn't as bad as most people thought it would have been.
100% agree with you there, Yosh. They won the first battle, pretty much tied the second. I mean, AYB still asking for the forfeit, unfortunately. It looks like we finally might see a battle with Apes pushing around Mushroom Building and Frogs coming west mid. They should see each other soon. They see each other now. Apes might have them caught. Here's a good time for some laws. There's the laws. Just a little bit off the mark, unfortunately. As Angry Frogs is a clean fall. Could have been an opening kill there if those laws were a little bit more on target.
Or if there had just been like maybe one or two more of them, they could have definitely got a kill in that choke for sure.
Yeah, their Marines were a little bit slow. I was hoping to see more than two laws, especially with most of them respawned with full explosives. It looks like Frogs are pushing around mid. Apes coming at the top. Not really a great spot for Apes. They don't have the bottom angle. Two great laws from Pliskin and Darth. This looks like it's going to be a rollover. Good idea I mean, nice job from that North group to recognize that the rest of their team was getting rolled. They turned in, got a couple kills in mid. Black Crusader and AYB running for their lives. AYB with some choice words for homosexuals in chat. Come on, AYB. Stop typing,
come on, you gotta
brother.
Clean that up.
Yeah.
He needs to just worry about the game.
Yeah, AYB's got to keep his emotions in check. new player. He's not used to the pressure of official league matches. And he looks like he's running north solo with Darth in hot pursuit. He should go down here. There shouldn't be.
I mean, AYB might be on tilt just a little bit here.
It's going to be interesting to talk to AYB after the game. Hopefully we can get him in here.
Well, the Apes have finally put Big Bird in. It's a little bit too late, though. I'm not sure who was spec'd for him, but at this point, it's too late for Big Bird to be able to do anything.
Yeah, it looks like they spec'd Therion, and Big Bird is a Grenader. It's a pretty good choice. I saw Therion. He was at a position a few times, took some opening deaths. I don't know why they waited so long to sub him in. Maybe he wasn't online. It's my best guess.
Yeah, I mean, a Grenader at this point's not going to do anything versus the Angry Frogs. Like, the Angry Frogs have already been talking shit to the Apes, telling them to push and everything, and they're just going to be lucky to get one more fight in.
Yeah, we have enemy sighted. AYB is going to be way out of position here. Solo med flank, I don't know what he's doing. Ate a lot of bullets. Lucky to get
He really needs
to
group with this team.
Yeah, I don't know what he's doing. He's going to be lucky to live. Yeah, he got out of it, which is good, but just a couple solo heals. He's got to get it together. Great nade from BB.
Oh, Big Bird!
Window, making his presence felt in his Season 3 debut. Big Bird, one of the old veterans. And a great pickup.
He just always seems to find himself. Big Bird just seems to find himself on these lower tier squads all the time. Last season didn't go very well with lifers. But the Apes are turning around with Big Bird in the game, but he might be leading for them now.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see him leading, and I think that's the right choice. AYB's got to control his emotions, and it's also harder to lead as a med. I mean, Kippa's been doing it, but I don't know many others who can handle that. Unfortunately, a bit of an ill-advised push, a few quick deaths, and with that, it looks like Frogs are up here. Romulus with the medic flank. Nice grenade.
Big Bird takes down another one.
Yeah, Big Bird's been doing well. Rom with the kill on the right side. It looks like Apes are up. No, even fight. A little bit of a medic fight going on north. There's two meds for Apes and one med for Frogs. 3v2 now. Can Darth get any kills? Darth goes down. Rom should go down here as well. It's interesting to see there's some respawn on both sides coming through. Great.
I mean, the Apes have numbers here.
Nosekeeper.
I mean, he's really done a lot.
He is definitely the MVP for Apes so far. Who'd you say is the Frog's MVP, Josh?
It would probably have to have been Pandy. I mean, Pandy hasn't played in 15 minutes now, and he's still ranking second.
Absolutely. Definitely MVP troll for sure. Frogs looks like they're in some bad spots. If Soldier dies south there. Nice job pushing through to save their team. Nice grenade from M. Soldier should die out of position. Good opening kill there. Nice angle from M, the captain of the Apes, making his veteran presence felt. AYB, I missed that, but he just took a death from a screen away from AR, and now he's whining in pub chat. AYB, step it up, buddy.
AYB. You gotta get it together, man. You just gotta focus on healing people. Maybe just pass off the leadership a little bit and just stop talking as much and focus on dodging the AR streams that's coming from a court away.
Yeah, one of the most important things for a leader is to stay positive. I haven't really been monitoring the time, but only 10 seconds left. 62-35 for Frogs, and that might be our final score. Quick death from Big Bird, and that's the final, 63-35, in favor of the Angry Frog. Thanks for coming on here, AYB. Tough loss to Angry Frogs, 62-35. tell me about your thoughts a bit. I noticed you getting down on yourself a little in chat there, talking about leading and medding at the same time. How do you feel right now?
Well, it was a lot harder than I thought it would be, because I haven't been trying to lead like at 100% during squad battles. So today was the first time where I was leading 100%, and I was just unable to med. I noticed I gave up basically all the free kills in the first part of the match.
I think that's a pretty fair assessment.
So that sort of, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's good that you're cognizant, you know what I mean, of what was going on. It's definitely hard to med and lead. Like, Kippa makes it look easy sometimes, but really tough to be leading the pack. I noticed you guys trying a lot of ambushes north for the first 10 minutes or so, and then you kind of went away from that and started moving around the map. Was it just not working for you, or you just decided to switch it up
a bit?
Well,
we lost the lead, and then I don't think they would come there again. So I just, in the spirit, in good sportsmanship, I didn't want to camp too hard while we were down.
That is very, very honorable of you. I'm not sure that all squads would have done the same. And all things considered, I mean, you guys lost by less than 30. I think that beat our pregame plus-minus prediction, Josh, a little bit, which isn't to take anything away from your performance. You know, you guys played quite well. I think you won the first battle, tied the second, and then it just got away from you a bit. So, you know, I'm pretty impressed. I mean, it definitely went way better than the Legends versus Cobra Kai game, which is the other kind of newer squad in Legends this season. Just tell me a bit about Nosekeeper. I mean, that guy's a monster. He had a great game.
Well, I've known him for a number of years now. I'm not sure exactly how many years, maybe 4 or 5. And, yeah, when I started playing with him in pub, I sort of noticed, hey, here's a guy I recognize, you know, let's play. And then I would notice that he would be able to pick up kills, not let people go, know when to push. And then eventually we started playing SBs as NTs. And then I noticed that he sort of had a grip on what USL was about. So we looked around, and then we decided to join SA because they were the least full team at the time.
Yeah, I gotta say that I'm really glad that you two decided to join SA rather than perhaps sitting on the bench for one of the top squads. Definitely, you know, two of the best pickups for SA. Obviously, Nosekeeper, their number one Marine, and if you're already leading as med, that can only mean good things down the road. Josh, do you have anything to say to AYB?
Yeah, you guys did very good in your first official match. It looked like at times you wanted to forfeit a little bit and that your emotions got a hold of you a little bit. Can you tell us a little bit about how you were feeling in that game?
Oh, actually, I felt great towards the end. Don't tell anyone, but I was just trolling them. I was saying that, but telling my team members, like, we got this, you know, let's keep playing. So hopefully it would make some of the other players on Angry Frog sort of more passive, and, you know, they would play less tight, they would start splitting more, and they would hopefully give up some fights, and then we would even up the score a little bit. So don't tell them that it was all a mind game.
AYB with the next level play.
With the mind games, boys.
The meta game. Wow. Psychological warfare. I love it. I love it. Thanks
and
so much
defense,
for coming on
I
here.
I think it worked a little.
It certainly did.
Yeah,
got us fooled.
Because they gave up about 20 more kills than I think they honestly should have, in my honest opinion. You know, not to disparage any of the players in the game. But, yeah, I think that once they had the lead, they could have done a better job holding on to it. Not that they didn't, but you know what I mean. They could have kept the gap just a bit better. But, you know, as long as everyone had fun, I think that's what's important.
Thank you so much, AYB. ER, welcome to Skirmish League Live, my friend. First off, Fantasy League. What was going on, buddy?
First, I want to thank my sponsor. I was just fucking playing around. I was having some technical difficulties, though. My gas pedal wasn't working.
Oh, not the gas pedal. I hope your steering wheel was okay.
No, the steering wheel was okay, but my gas pedal wasn't working, so I couldn't aim. So for next week, I'm going to be good to go. So guys, pick me.
Oh, that's
pick ER fantasy next week.
I don't know if anybody's gonna trust that ER, but you heard it from the man himself. Pick ER next week. I noticed you law a wall the first battle. Like, I was actually specking you. I was expecting big things. You know, I consider you to be the number one player on the frogs, and you kind of just turned into a physic and lawed. Can you tell me a bit about what happened there?
It was the gas pedal, my friend. I told you. Like, I'm trying to aim, but the gas pedal's not working. So I cannot put enough gas so I can actually shoot the law.
Sounds like ER needs a interesting USL mechanic.
Yeah, it's really technical. Sometimes you have to shift to strafe left and shift to strafe right. So I'm always shifting. It's different.
All right.
But it was a good game. It was a good game.
Did you? Was there more competition from Apes than you guys expected?
I think they do a great job. I think that was getting frustrated a little bit. But after that, I think they did a really good job.
Yeah, I noticed you guys get caught, I think, like, the first two battles, really. I saw Darth, he was getting quite aggressive. You were just kind of pushing through the chokes, and unfortunately, Apes was there to punish you guys. But towards the end, I mean, obviously, your veteran skill and leadership and whatnot took over. Who would you say, I saw Darth was MVP. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, he's always the leader, so the leader should always break or make the game. But I think at the beginning we just playing around and we just push anything that we wanted. But it was harder than we thought.
Absolutely. I think both of us predicted a slightly higher margin of victory. Although, I mean, I'm pretty, like, you guys didn't lose your heads. You know, you're down a bit the first battle and certainly came back pretty strong. Can you say something to all of the Skirmish Fantasy League players, your fans, quote-unquote? I know you said a little bit before, but I believe you were the number one picked player this week on both on my and Yosh's teams. I mean, I saw Pandy trolling. Can you just say a few words to, you know, Fantasy League players?
Yeah, they're like my gas pedal, my friend. I'm telling you, it's not working. Just wait for next week.
Sounds like you need a new car, my friend.
Yeah. No, always just joking, though. I just say, like, I want to just say thank you to everyone, though. Everyone, I think, is doing a great job, from the captains, from champion to fucking armor. So I think everyone needs to keep doing whatever they're doing and keep growing the league, but, because we know it's growing right now. More people are playing it, so let's keep doing that.
Thanks for coming on, ER, and talking to all your fantasy haters now, I'm sure. I mean, 2-2 performance, that's not what people were expecting out of you. I certainly expected better. You let me down, ER.
Nah, it's alright, man. It's just a game, but in the end, it's fun.
It's all good, brother.
All right.
Get your gas pedal sorted out next week.
I will. Take care, guys.
And that's it for our show today. In week one of season 3 of Free Infantry, we just watched Angry Frogs defeat the Statutory Apes 63-35. I want to thank my co-host Yosh and everybody else for watching. For more information and great clips, please be sure to check out our YouTube channel, Skirmish League Live, and visit the website, uslzone.com. This is Prisoner, signing off. Goodbye.